from the cells of long-term solitary confinement, echoed in the dormitories and cell blocks from Virginia to Oregon. We prisoners across the United States vow to finally end slavery in 2016. On September 9th of 1971, prisoners took over and shut down Attica, New York State's most notorious prison. On September 9th of 2016, we will begin an action to shut down prisons all across the country. We will not only demand the end to prison slavery, we will end it ourselves by ceasing to be slaves. In the 1970s, the U.S. prison system was crumbling. In Walpole, San Quentin, Soledad, Angola, and many other prisons, people were standing up, fighting, and taking ownership of their lives and bodies back from the plantation prisons. For the last 6 years, we have remembered and renewed that struggle. In the interim, the prisoner population has ballooned, and technologies of control and confinement have developed into the most sophisticated and repressive in world history. The prisons have become more dependent on slavery and torture to maintain their stability. Prisoners are forced to work for little or no pay. That is slavery. The 13th Amendment to the U.S. Constitution maintains a legal exception for continued slavery in the U.S. prisons. It states, neither slavery nor involuntary servitude, except as in punishment for crime, whereof the party shall have been duly convicted, shall exist within the United States. Overseers watch over our every move, and if we do not perform our appointed tasks to their liking, we are punished. They may have replaced the whip with pepper spray, but many of the other torments remain. Isolation, restraint positions, stripping off our clothes, and investigating our bodies as though we are animals. Slavery is alive and well in the prison system, but by the end of this year, it won't be anymore. This is a call to end slavery in America. This call goes directly to the slaves themselves. We are not making demands or requests of our captors. We are calling ourselves to action. To every prisoner in every state and federal institution across this land, we call on you to stop being a slave, to let the crops rot in the plantation fields, to go on strike and cease reproducing the institutions of your confinement. This is a call for a nationwide prisoner work stoppage to end prison slavery, starting on September 9th, 2016.
Yeah.
They cannot run these facilities without us! Nonviolent protests, work stoppages, hunger strikes, and other refusals to participate in prison routines and needs have increased in recent years. The 2010 Georgia prison strike, the massive rolling California hunger strike, the Free Alabama Movement's 2014 work stoppage have gathered the most attention, but they are far from the only demonstrations of prisoner power. Large, sometimes effective hunger strikes have broken out at Ohio State Penitentiary, at Menard Correctional in Illinois, at Red Onion in Virginia, as well as many other prisons. The burgeoning resistance movement is diverse and interconnected, including immigrant detention centers, women's prisons, and juvenile facilities. Last fall, women prisoners at Yuba County Jail in California joined a hunger strike initiated by women held in immigrant detention centers in California, Colorado, and Texas. Prisoners all across the country regularly engage in myriad demonstrations of power on the inside. They have most often done so with convict solidarity, building coalitions across race lines and gang lines to confront the common oppressor. 45 years after Attica, the waves of change are returning to America's prisons. This September, we hope to coordinate and generalize these protests to build them into a single tidal shift that the American prison system cannot ignore or withstand. We hope to end prison slavery by making it impossible by refusing to be slaves any longer. To achieve this goal, we need support from people on the outside. A prison is an easy lockdown environment.
a place of control and confinement, where repression is built into every stone wall and chain link, every gesture and routine. When we stand up to these authorities, they come down on us. And the only protection we have is solidarity from the outside. Mass incarceration, whether in private or state-run facilities, is a scheme where slave catchers patrol our neighborhoods and monitor our lives. It requires mass criminalization. Our tribulations on the inside are a tool used to control our families and communities on the outside. Certain Americans live every day under not only the threat of extrajudicial execution as protests surrounding the deaths of Mike Brown, Tamir Rice, Sandra Bland, and so many others have drawn long overdue attention to, but also under the threat of capture, of being thrown into these plantations, shackled, and forced to work. Our protest against prison slavery is a protest against the school-to-prison pipeline, a protest against police terror, a protest against post-release control. When we abolish slavery, they'll lose much of their incentive to lock up our children. They'll stop building traps to pull back those who they've released. When we remove the economic motive and grief of our forced labor from the U.S. prison system, the entire structure of courts and police, of control and slave catching, must shift to accommodate us as humans rather than slaves. Prison impacts everyone. When we stand up and refuse on September 9, 2016, we need to know our friends, families, and allies on the outside will have our backs. This spring and summer will be seasons of organizing, of spreading the word, building the networks of solidarity, and showing that we're serious in what we're capable of. Woo! Step up, stand up, and join us against prison slavery for liberation of all. I found this online, and I don't have much time here tonight, so I'm going to leave you all with something I wrote when I was locked up. I wasn't locked up for long, but it was long enough to know the bullshit that it's all about. So here it is. Fuck this place, this life, this waste of time behind the kind of line drawn with gunfire by men for hire and barbed wire. But don't you call me the liar, because I'm in this shit, where in every direction are stone-cold walls made of fucking brick, doors with locks that go slam-click, and the glass is so damn thick I can feel it in the air. Fuck this place, this life, this waste of breath. Because in here, there's no such thing as love or fear, just a point with an edge. And whether I fall off or cut from ear to ear, every moment feels like the end draws near. And when it's the scent, it's like life is spent, every last cent with nothing to show but the check signed and sent, even though I know there's not enough dough in the bank to make rent. Oh, they're gonna fucking do me. So all I can do is lay back, kick off my shoes, relax, and enjoy the bad news. Then I'm done, son. I lose. Fuck this place, this life, this waste of space. Cause it's not yours and it's not mine, it's ours. So as I rest my case, don't you look me face to face, and don't you tell me I know what you mean. Cause you don't, and you won't. Cause you weren't aware and you're not, you weren't there and you're not yet aware. They just glare with their damn blank stare. See, you didn't see where what I saw. Where the criminals are made of stone and the lawmen are made of straw, the truth turns to fire and he who burns is the liar. That is this place, this life, this waste. So fuck it, incarceration.